Hi, this is Jeff Uhlenhake in the Ohio State weight room. I'd like to welcome back Athletic Strength and Power. We're here to do some neck training, manual resistance neck, as well as the Pendulum four-way neck machine. And, you know, I've had the ability to, fortunately, to play football here as well as coach here. I've trained under some great strength coaches in my lifetime, as well as in the NFL. Some very notable people had the opportunity to do manual resistance and a very varying neck machines. And so I'd like to take you through a few of these things and the way we do it at Ohio State. At Ohio State, our general protocol is that we'll do two sets of six, four-way neck. We'll do it a minimum of two times per week. We can break that up into a set of manual resistance and a set of four-way neck machine. There are other times where we might do a set of 10 four-way. There's no greater important exercise in this weight room than neck. That is the way we feel as a staff for the safety of our players. We'd be not doing our duties as strength coaches if we didn't train the neck. So when we have it, if there's a downtime in our weight room, we'll send a guy over for another set of neck. If we have a full team workout, and they're, you know, you might be waiting for another group of guys to get done, we'll have guys get down and do another set of manual neck. You cannot do too much neck as far as we're concerned. And so basically, we're going to head over to the bench. We're going to do four-way neck manual resistance. Okay, we're going to do manual four-way with our great intern here, Nick Savage. Nick's going to help us out. We are going to emphasize to Nick, just like we'd emphasize to our player, what's expected of the player. Nick, I'm going to expect you to always work in the fashion, in the concentric phase. You know, a nice, you're working as hard as you can. I'm going to make it about a 1 to 2 count coming up. And then in the eccentric phase, I want to make sure you're fighting it down. Do this in a very non-jerky motion, just a nice steady fight. I'll provide all the pressure you need at about a 4 or 5 second clip. So Nick's gonna get down for neck flexion. He's gonna have his palms up. So as our players respond to this, we don't really call it flexion extension, back of the neck, front of the neck, okay? He's not using his hands to press off the ground, okay? Starting from the bottom, he's gonna come up with a nice smooth motion coming up. Come on up, Nick. Hard, 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 hard. 1,001, 1,002. He's going to keep pressing into my hand. The spotter's going to initiate the movement down. 3, 4, 5. Up. Good. Fight down, fight down, fight down. 3, 4, 5. Up. Come, come, come. Bring it, bring it, bring it, bring it, bring it. He's looking up and top through his eyes. Down, down, down. Fight it, fight it, fight it, fight it. Up. I'm sure not to press through the bottom, squeeze, squeeze at the top, contract at the top, press down. You're pressing up, I'm pressing down, excuse me. Up, 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 finish, 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 finish. Squeeze, 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 and press down. Good, Nick, good. So the timing of it is the rep is gonna take approximately 6-7 seconds for 6 reps. You know, you're working in somewhere between 30 and 40 seconds for the through the entire set. Nick, go ahead and flip on your back. Flip on your back. Okay. Okay. In all these, we want the spotter to have a hand on the body. Okay. We'll make sure that the guy is secure on the bench. Nick, same thing here. Let's make sure we tuck our chin to our chest. Okay, neck flexion, all right, front of the neck, tucking our chin. Squeeze at the top. When you come down to the bottom, don't relax. Okay, we don't want any herky-jerky movements. And all these movements, follow your eyes. Whichever direction you're going, follow your eyes. Okay? Go ahead, Nick. Hit it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Bringing your shoulders up just a little bit too much. Just tuck the chin. 4, 5, up, 1, 2, 3. Press into my hand, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up. That's it, that's it, that's it. Press into my hand, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Up. Come on. Fight it down. Fight. That's it. One more, Nick. One more. Up. That's it. Shoulders down. That's it. That'll way to correct it on the go. Okay, so one of the things that we really try to work on is that we're working out of the neutral position. Go ahead and sit up, Nick. And down at the bottom, I do not want to jerk his head down into the pad. I am working him as hard as I can into that contracted state at the top where he's brought it all the way up to the top. Hey, I want him to really contract at the top and press into my hand, and I'll push him down. Drive is probably a bad terminology. I'll push him down at a nice steady pace. He has to fight it out as best as he can. But at the bottom range, we're going to ease up. We're going to ease up a little bit. So Nick, let's go down to side. Okay, we want to make sure our body's nice and in line on the bench. He's not going to sway. Once again, as a spotter, I'm going to have a firm hand there to help him out. Same thing as before. He's got his palm upside down on the floor. Supinated would be the proper term. So he's got his palm up. He's not going to press off the floor. We are going full range of motion here, just like we were on neck extension, okay? So he is gonna work full range, but from this neutral spot down, I'm not gonna push down real hard. I'm gonna actually give him a slight stretch. I'm gonna let him initiate the movement up, and then from midway up, I'm gonna resist more. And so Nick's job is to push as hard as he can from midway up, to press up at the top, to contract the neck muscle at the top, and then I'll initiate the movement down. That's the same as before, but I'm just gonna give him a gentle stretch at the bottom. Okay, Nick starting at the bottom. Ready, up. Good, squeeze, resist. Like I said, the neck muscle, especially at the side, that's a lot of different moving parts in the neck. It's something you need to be very careful with. It's not like training certain other body parts where maybe if your technique is a little bit off, that you can get away with it. In terms of the neck, let's be safe. Let's be sure about what we're doing, which we at Ohio State are very sure in the way we train our neck. That's it, squeeze. He's looking to his left, so his head doesn't get rotated. It's nice and straight ahead, looking to his left. Good, Nick. One more. Squeeze to the top. Good. And Nick let me initiate all the movement down. He kept the pressure on the neck the entire time. Go ahead, sit up for a second. So as we do neck, like I said, we're looking for total time involved. We're not going to have you do the other side, Nick. That was basically the ability to train your neck over time. Have the resistance be very similar throughout time. Nick is going to tire more as the set goes on. You got a lot of guys out there with really, really strong necks. So when you are spotting them on neck, don't worry about the first few times. Have them maintain their resistance throughout and have them slow down a little bit. They'll tire, and as a spotter, you'll be able to do it better. But Nick and I have to work together. We have to work together. He has to trust me, and I have to trust him. And that is the biggest part of manual resistance. Whether you're doing a side manual raise for your side delts, front delts, or your neck. Regardless of that, you have to work together in manual resistance to get the end result that you want. Continuing with neck, we're now over with our pendulum four-way neck machine. Nick, go ahead and step right in for neck flexion. This is a pendulum machine that has adjustments so you can adjust it. We have it on 12 for Nick and for all of our guys. Go ahead and engage, Nick. So we have our guys get in and sit. Now go ahead and continue on with the exercise. He's just in a very nice, smooth motion. Looking for, obviously we want to push as hard as we can and then slow on the way down, or the way up in this case. We don't want any jerking from any other part of the body. We want a firm grip with our arms, but we don't want to pull with our shoulders. He's actually got his shoulders retracted back slightly, which is great. And his core is engaged, but we want to isolate the neck, and Nick's doing a great job of that. He doesn't have any jerking motions here, just like over on manual resistance. It's very smooth motion. He would be able to handle more weight than this. That's fine, Nick, you can stop. As I said, we do 6 reps. Sometimes we'll do 10. We want our players to be able to go up in weight only if they're doing it in a safe and secure manner. Oftentimes they might be able to do 10 reps, but even though they got 10 reps, the neck, that's a certain area of the body you just got to be very careful with about adding weight and creating momentum. A lot of kids, right when they get in here, they want to drive with their shoulders. We are really consistently talking to them about sitting in the center of the chair, so as when they engage, they're completely upright with their body. Nick, go ahead and go with Nick, neck extension. Nick, okay. So he engages in the neck, and he is doing a great job in terms of looking up with his eyes. This is one that's full range of motion. Okay. He's able to go full range of motion in this manner. The only thing we're not going full range of motion on is the front of the neck. Sitting nice and upright, his hands are on his quad. It's a smooth movement down. We really like our guys to go in the eccentric phase or the lowering of the weight at about a 5-second clip here. So they should be over here. If they're over here for 10 reps, you know, a set's gonna take about 60 seconds. It's awesome. Great reps, Nick, great reps. He's following his eyes, follow his eyes. And last rep. Now, one thing for these guys is that oftentimes they'll do the front of the neck, and a lot of our guys will, for this particular neck machine, the pendulum, they'll lower the seat one notch to feel a little bit more comfortable in the range of motion. So Nick, go ahead. Let's see, we did your left side on manual. We're gonna hit his right side on the pendulum neck machine and even out the neck. So he's just gonna get one set on each side of lateral neck. He's gonna get 2 good sets, 1 manual, 1 machine for flexion and extension. Or forward and backwards, as our players here at Ohio State, we like to call it. He's reaching across with the opposite arm. At times we'll reach, we like to fit the kids in and see if they're comfortable. He can grab with the right arm also. The big thing is we don't want any movement out of the shoulders that initiate the neck going in that direction. Everything's smooth, a 5 count. And he is just working slightly past neutral. It's a great job, Nick. Great job. Go ahead and hop up. Basically, here at Ohio State, we're able to train the neck. We've got everything we need in our Ohio State weight room. Coach Marotti and the rest of the staff, we're all on the same page with our neck training. We want to make sure that the players understand what's expected of them. Football is a violent game. There's a lot of different areas that guys get whipped around. There's head-on collisions. Guys fall to the ground, their head whips back and hits the ground. There's a lot of studies out there on concussions, you know, varying degrees. The game is a very violent game. It's a fun game, but it can be brutal. So for the most part, we want to make sure our players are trained effectively, make sure that they have as much girth as they can in the neck and the shoulder area. In the trapezoid area to make sure that they're ready and prepared to play this great game of football. Thank you.